Well, millions of Australians with university student loans are about to have hundreds of dollars or more wiped from their HECS debts in a major budget overhaul.
It's huge news. For more, we're joined by Nine's National Affairs Editor Andrew Probyn at Parliament House in Canberra. Andrew, good morning. Thanks for your time as always. How's this all going to work?
Well, this is, as James was saying, really big news for 3 million Australians. Not hundreds of dollars that will be saved by most, but many thousands of dollars. Remember, the average HECS debt is about $27,000. Now, since HECS was introduced in 89, it's been indexed by inflation. That's about to change. They now want to index it by whichever is smaller, wage price index or inflation. Now, as we know, last year we all copped massive cost of living pressures, 7.1% increase to HECS because that reflected inflation. So that's about $1,900 that people copped on an average HECS debt. What's interesting about what the government has announced, or will announce today, is that they will not only change the indexation arrangements, but retrospectively make this date it back to June last year. So someone who copped $1,900 on an average HECS bill will now be something like $1,200 better off. So it's a big deal. Does it affect the budget? Well, it does in the short term at about $3 billion, but last year and this year, they're unusual years insofar as inflation is way beyond the growth of wages. So I think in the long run, the government will able to catch up the cost of this particular expense, $3 billion over the next 4 years. But it's going to be of great interest to many, many Australians and will be greatly relieved.
Yeah, and also easing a lot of financial anxiety that they'd be feeling watching this debt just mount up so much. As you said, the government trying to ease costs of living. We know the budget's coming up next weekend. What can we expect later this month in that budget?
Well, the budget is a week on Tuesday. We can expect a few things. We can expect another budget surplus, which is one of the reasons why the government will want to give some cost of living relief. But it has to be really, really careful because it doesn't want to be spending too much, because if it spends too much, it only will worsen inflation. We'll have those tax cuts that come in on July 1st. We can expect also some power bill relief, but that will be pretty similar to what happened last year, and that will be dependent on a lot of negotiation with the states and territories who are likely to pay some of that relief.
Andrew, I want to ask you about this new app that's being introduced. Australians can now find out in real time if their personal data has been compromised. Sounds good. How's it going to work?
Well, we already have something called the Credential Protection Register, which was set up after the Optus breach, where 10 million Australians had their data breached, their private data breached. Now, this register sort of sits somewhere on the internet. The government wants to introduce this smartphone app, which will tell people in real time whether their data has been breached. Now, of course, it depends on people actually downloading the app, and this will be an interesting exercise in and of itself, because it's no use having an app if no one actually uses it. But importantly, too, it won't stop fraud. It'll just tell people that their data is being used by someone for identity theft or crime, and it will be up to that individual to contact the institutional company to ensure it doesn't happen.
All right. Andrew Probyn, live in Canberra, thank you.
Thanks, Andrew.
Thanks, guys.
Will they or won't they? The RBA board meets this week after taking a break last month, and homeowners are now sweating on that interest rate decision.
Let's bring in Sally Tindall from RateCity. Sally from RateCity.
There's nothing silly about RateCity.
Nothing silly about Sally.
You can call me silly from RateCity, but
thank you, Sally. Okay, the all important question: will they hike the cash rate? Will they drop it? What will they do?
They will not move a muscle. The RBA has been in a holding pattern for 3 meetings so far, and there's a sense of inertia happening here. They've got a wait and see approach, and it's not surprising because when you look at the inflation, it's coming down beautifully. The 13 rate hikes have been working, But when you start peeling back the layers of that inflation data, as the RBA no doubt will do from tomorrow, which is when the meeting starts, you can find a lot of cracks. You only have to look at that monthly indicator. So if you look at the data on the monthly level, it's been stagnant for the last 3 months at 3.4% and actually went up in the most recent data set. Only by a small fraction, but it went up. So, you know, that's not great news from the RBA's point of view, but I don't think it's enough to trigger a hike, that's for certain.
Okay.
The RBA's statement will make for really important reading. Is that fair to say? Because they have the potential to put us on notice. Will they put us on notice, do you think?
I think they will. It's a big question. Look, we know from the minutes of the last meeting that at the last meeting they did not consider the case for a hike. That was the first time they didn't consider a hike since April 22. That's 20 meetings of considering hikes. The last one they didn't. I think they're going to go back to considering a hike. I think they're going to go back to putting us on notice. If you look at the data, unemployment still incredibly low at 3.8%. Property prices just saw the, I think CoreLogic is saying, the 15th month of growth. It's ridiculous. Then you've got money in the bank. It's at a new record high of $1.47 trillion. That all gives them cover to fire off another rate hike if they need to. They're not going to do it willy-nilly, that's for sure, and they're going to give us plenty of warning.
Okay. So if they do give us warning that there will be a rate hike, what would that hike look like for borrowers?
All right, so on a $500,000 debt at the start of the hikes, you're talking about $74 extra on your monthly mortgage repayments, which is not huge, obviously, but when you add it up across what would then be 14 hikes, you're talking about $1,284. This is a huge amount to repay. So borrowers should start preparing for a hike just in case. And the way to do that is to pick up the phone to your bank on Monday morning and haggle for a lower interest rate. Even if you got 0.25 knocked off your interest rate now and you kept your monthly repayments exactly the same, you will have future-proofed your finances for another hike.
And Sally, you were just telling us in the ad break that banks are actually making it easier for us to ask those questions.
Yeah, I've seen on Westpac's page that you can, it says, do you want to negotiate a lower rate? And then the other day I was on my bank's website on a Sunday and I saw a contact us, you know, form. I filled it out because come Monday morning I've, you know,
busy
with work, right? So I filled it out on Sunday. And then, of course, at 10:30 on Monday morning, the bank called me and then we started negotiating. It was fantastic. We were done by about 10:40, I think.
Okay.
Fill out the form. It's fantastic.
Ask the question.
Yeah, today. Fill out the form today. Get the phone call tomorrow.
Get out your laptop. Do it on your phone right now while you're watching Weekend Today.
Yeah.
Rate City. The best in the business.
Not silly at all. Thank you, Sally.
Thanks, Sal.
Thank you.